My specialty is the archaeology of the American Southwest, and with Barnard students, I've been helping to study and really transform the archaeology of the Northern Rio Grande portion of the Southwest.
This summer, we excavated a unit in an old trash midden, very specific deposits, which are going to tell us a lot about kind of the history of this area and what people were eating and consuming in different ways.
Barnard Toddler Center is a really unique living laboratory at Barnard College. We are affiliated with the psychology department. We have students who work in the classroom and learn about early development. We have an observation room. We have people from all over the world, graduate students in Barnard and Columbia, students who come and observe and learn about early development.
Doing research at the Toddler Center at Barnard with Tova was a wonderful educational experience because it really introduced me to what was involved in doing research with developmental populations, and it really set the stage for the rest of my career. After having done research in a number of institutions across the country, I was able to come back to this campus, which I've always loved being at, and it's wonderful to set up my lab here, but also continue collaborations with the person that mentored me from the beginning.
SRI stands for the Summer Research Institute. SRI provides every young woman who has a research mentor the opportunity to work in a scientific lab over the course of the summer. It pays every student who finds a research mentor, and it exposes her to amazing research and the ability to publish articles.
My research this summer focuses on the brain master clock that's in control of your body's daily rhythms. My research is supported by Barnard and also by the National Science Foundation.
While I came into Barnard not knowing a thing about research, I've only started this past summer, and I've already noticed a huge difference in just the way I think and the way I approach different problems that come up in the lab, and it's been a really noticeable difference to me.
This is the base camp of the Fred Lawrence Whipple Observatory, and we have the four Veritas telescopes here at the site, and we use them for high-energy gamma-ray astrophysics research.
I'm analyzing one specific source, a BLX source, which is the center of an active galaxy, and I'm looking at Veritas data and putting together the data.
Barnard students have traditionally worked on Veritas research with me in the summers, so they start out as summer interns, and sometimes when they make sufficient progress, they carry out throughout the year, and we involve them throughout the academic year. They get the chance to work with people not just at Barnard, but because of the work through Veritas, they collaborate with people across America as well as Europe.
This summer, I'm helping the archives make a podcast, and the first episode is about how to navigate the archives, and I'm creating that episode specifically through the lens of Entozake Shange's archive.
Entozake Shange is a Black feminist writer and graduate of Barnard College. I'd put in my proposal that I wanted to do a couple of podcasts that would introduce students to archival work. Danielle and I talked more about sound and how she experiences the archive sonically. I thought it would actually be better, given her expertise, to do an audio podcast.
This is a really great opportunity for the students to get away from campus and to really work one-on-one with a faculty member in an intensive 24/7 type of environment. We work together, we cook together, we learn together. And for me, this is one of the most gratifying pedagogical experiences that I've had as a professor.
The students work alongside a faculty mentor producing original research. What an amazing opportunity for our students, and what a unique opportunity for our faculty to work closely with their research mentees.